Welcome back.
I'm sorry. He was giving one of our guests a hard time, so I was laughing.
Well, you got the floor. Go ahead.
Hi. We have Lane Ragsdale with us, and Lane is no stranger to the studio. We're glad
she's
to
even
have
been
you.
In this seat several times.
That's right.
And
you've
she
had
probably
a...
will be again someday.
I make her nervous if I'm here very often, so she comes much more consistently.
Exactly.
But we decided she's much scarier than I am.
That's what she said.
Mm-hmm.
That's what what?
Who said she?
Oh, she you,
did.
Who
I
said
did.
That she, yeah, she's scarier
than I said
Lane
is more quiet and demure and any little quieter, and I'm just loud. She may be smarter than me, but I'm louder.
Mm-hmm. I don't know about that.
Well, you're going to talk to us about your brainstorm.
I am.
And it's called The Nest.
The Nest Financial.
Okay. And what is that?
Well, it's really interesting. I started, as you all know, because I came and did some segments here.
Yeah.
You bet.
I started as a financial advisor with Centurion Financial. Mm-hmm. Ken Sabell's there in 2005. And loved being there and loved being associated with Ken. And back last fall, he was looking at going back and getting an additional license where he could manage off-site facilities and be able, it's called, in our world, it's called a OSJ. It's a different level to where you can supervise other people. And he started looking at doing that. And then all of a sudden, as you said, it was a brainstorm, and it really was. I was in the shower one day, I think. And I got to thinking about a business model called the Nest Financial. And Nest standing for dealing with people to do financial planning for a needs analysis for the N, an evaluation of their assets that they have is the E, coming up with the strategy to strategize what they're going to do with their financial future. And then T was taking charge of their financial future. And it just all fell into place. And it was kind of neat. You know, by the time I got out of the shower, I went and checked. There was not another Nest Financial in the United States doing the same type thing. The nestfinancial.com was available.
Oh, wow.
And 741-NEST for our phone number here was available.
It was
and
a
I
perfect
thought, it was,
scenario.
It was. And so I had the opportunity. I went back and talked to Ken about it. He was very supportive with the licensing changing he did. It allowed him to become my offsite supervisor. I moved my office home, or actually started my business out of my home, still associated with him as the auditing function and compliance function is what they call it in our world. And then I was with LPL, as you all know, I'm an LPL financial advisor as the broker-dealer. Talked to them, and they allowed me to start the business under them with him as my OSJ. All my clients came with me. There was no changes. There was no nothing. So it was. There were about 15 things that could have gone wrong in the planning, and it took about 6 months to get in, and every one of them fell in place just perfectly.
Now, you're making a lot of people out there jealous.
Well,
because
I
a lot
love
of things in their life,
it.
They would like to everything to fall into place like
it
that.
It is. It is.
But this doesn't happen to you every day.
No. This happens to me very rarely. When you were talking to Keith Kovacs about the red tape, I understand red tape to a huge degree.
And that's what stops a lot of people from their a dream that they are so passionate about, and that passion gets snuffed out by red tape or somebody that's in power that says, no, that's not going to happen. Get out of my way.
Yes,
and then
it does. And, you know, I can never thank Ken enough.
We should do a show on just how to combat that at some point.
He was very supportive. The hardest thing that as a financial planner that you have to be so careful with is people's personal identification. So that's a huge issue in somebody starting a business from home because everything has to be as secured as it would be if you were in a bank building or at, you know, a corporate office somewhere. And I wanted to be able to go to my clients' homes if I needed to work on the road if I needed to, because as one person, you don't have a backup there. And so how do you alleviate that concern of people that you want to make a change and, you know, you're gone for a day or something? So I do everything on a laptop, and that was the hardest part of getting everything set up. Everything has to be very encrypted on a laptop. My laptop is set up to where you have to have passwords to get in, my fingerprint to get it on, and a special key that
your
it
fingerprint?
Won't come out. My fingerprint. Yes, it's fingerprint technology.
So is that a separate device that fits onto your computer?
It actually came with the computer I bought.
Oh, wow.
And it's a certain type operating system and on the computer to where you scan your fingerprint and it comes up. And LPL was great. I got a technical person there who worked from home some. And so he was telling me, here's what you need to do, and here you need to go buy this, you need to do that. And then everything has to be backed up off-site,
right,
encrypted as well, which took weeks at times,
yeah,
to do. But, it, you know, getting through that red tape, it's finding one person that will work with you and help you, and that's what I found. Mm-hmm. And then I went to the computer store, you know, bought a computer off the shelf, and they helped me, you know, put it together and,
wow,
worked with me for, again, several weeks in there to get it going. But very secure to where I can be on the road somewhere and pull over if you call me, and I can make a trade or look up your account and the whole bit from, you,
yeah,
know, sitting on the side of the road somewhere now with, mm-hmm, a hot spot now.
So if you, wow, possibly on the beach somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. On the boat at the lake. No. I'm scared to take anything around water. It's,
yeah,
my,
exactly,
only problem. I'm scared. I work, yeah, so hard to get it set up.
Yeah.
I'm scared to death that,
yeah,
I'm going to do something to it and damage it or something.
That's amazing.
Yeah. But it has been wonderful. And I love the opportunity of working at home. I had financial advisors tell me, you know, when you first start in the business, they say, you know, you need to work really hard for 5 years and go out, you know, and think of all your friends as prospects and go, mm-hmm, get their money and on and on. And that wasn't the business model I wanted. It's, mm-hmm, a successful one and it can work for people, but it's not my nature. And so I wanted to look more at the idea of I want my clients to be my friends and, mm-hmm, being able to work with them. And so that takes longer. That's a much longer conversation when you start out with people. You know, what really are your needs? Help me understand that. And what do you have everywhere? I don't have to,
yeah,
manage them all. Just what do you have? And help me work through,
mm-hmm,
that. And then let's plan a strategy. It can be months and months and sometimes longer before there really is a business transaction. And sometimes the best advice I can give to people is, you're fine,
mm-hmm,
just the way you are. Don't,
mm-hmm,
don't,
mm-hmm,
go down this path. You know,
mm-hmm,
what you're doing with your business or this or that is working.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to be licensed a little differently to do that. Not only am I licensed as a stockbroker, I'm licensed where I can do what's called advisory, which I can just give advice and,
mm-hmm,
be paid for the,
mm-hmm,
advice part, either through assets that I manage or just advice, mm-hmm, to people.
Well, what's the frustration level, though, when you say it's taking 3 months to work with this client,
uh-huh,
to maybe see any kind of return,
mm-hmm,
and then you've got a light bill you've got to pay?
Well, you have to have enough in the pipeline,
mm-hmm,
that something is coming along
all the time.
And the nice thing about being able to start as I did is my clients that I already had that just moved with me,
right,
the money that they're putting in on a monthly basis, if it's a retirement plan or something like,
mm-hmm,
that, helps pay the light bill,
mm-hmm,
until the overall business model allows it to be completely self-sustaining,
yep,
on what's coming in. And I think the joy of that and my hope for that is the slower you go at something, the longer it's going to stay with you.
Mm-hmm.
That's true in weight loss. The slower,
mm-hmm,
you lose weight, the,
yes,
longer it,
yeah,
takes to put it back
there.
In. And when I, my old days at Millbrook, or whatever name, Mass Merchandisers, all the names I was there under, we had a philosophy called plan better, grow faster. And that the better that you plan, the faster you're able to achieve,
mm-hmm,
your goals.
Mm-hmm.
And I think a lot of this is the planning and laying the foundation for my clients as well as for my own business,
yeah,
that lasts,
right,
you know, for years and years and years. And
how long
have
you been
plan.
In this business?
Started in 2005.
Okay.
Got in and got my licenses at the beginning of 2006. Got really hitting the ground and going about the time 2008.
Yeah,
the market
you
went down.
You're updated all the time.
We
mean,
are.
You have to keep.
Yes. I sit
education.
On a conference call every morning at 7:45 with the analysts at LPL. So you get an idea of what caused market variations, what they expect the next day,
oh, really?
As well as how they feel you should be positioned for immediate to long-term growth.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's very comforting because the news media a lot of times play up on the negative aspects,
right,
whether it's,
mm-hmm,
the debt ceiling or this, that, and the other.
Yeah.
And that's comforting to after you are subjected to that all day long and listening and hearing,
mm-hmm,
and people concerned, very concerned,
yes,
about their future and their savings, you know, are calling you. LPL's one of their biggest claims and one of their largest strengths is they offer objective advice. And so to every day to listen to those people who that's what they do for a living,
mm-hmm,
to sit down and tell you, here's how we think it plays out and here's what you need to be aware of for your clients today, it's really comforting to me. Because as an individual person working on your own,
mm-hmm,
you want to be able to go and know that you're listening to somebody you feel you can trust.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
You bet.
Now,
mm-hmm,
are you different than what happens on the stock market? Because those are basically just traders that trade things day in and day,
uh-huh,
out.
I can do that. That's part of what my licensing is.
Okay.
I tell people that come to me, if you're really wanting a day trader, I'm probably the wrong person for you. Mm-hmm. Because I want to look at the long term. I enjoy that better. And my business cards, and I brought business cards for y'all and I forgot to drop them. But the back of my business card, in addition to what the NEST stands for, says that my goal is for you to be making better financial decisions with my help. I don't think any of us can tell you that we have all the answers and we know what the market's going to do and on and on. And that we can guarantee you that you're going to have a great a great financial future because you work with me. What I do want to guarantee you is that, or tell you, is that I want to help you make better decisions than you would on your own. And because of that, the day trading, people can be very successful at it, but it is a full-time separate job. You have to be watching every news account. You've got to know what the Bernanke's going to say today in the news conference and all that kind of stuff. And I'd much rather be worrying about you and your wife and what you want to do in 10 years. That's what I enjoy, and that's where my real love for the business is. And there's lots of things. Your financial plan is not just stocks. It is looking at what your long-term care needs may be, what your life insurance may be, how you deal with an elderly parent. You've been through that. You know, all of those things play into a successful financial plan. And to me, that's much more fascinating than what two or three stocks are going to do today.
Yeah.
There are people that are good at that.
But these are, this is an important part of it.
It
is. What you're doing,
it is.
So.
It is not just about making your bank account grow. It's making the best use of the assets that you have overall. And that may not just be money. You know, that's your Social Security income in the future. That's your earning potential now. That's all of that goes into a really good financial plan.
Right.
And I'm loving it. I just love it.
Good.
Interesting.
That's
great. Yeah. Let me ask you another question. You talked about it's not only about money, and you talk about other assets. What about land and those kind of things? Is that
It does play into it also? It plays into it really large in two ways. One is, what are your tax ramifications? You know, you can have land and then find out as you get ready to retire to sell that, you end up paying so much in taxes. So people go, well, I'll just go ahead and give it to my kids and then they can give me. Well, there's all kinds of tax ramifications around that. I'm not a tax advisor, but as we work with people, they need to think of that. Businesses, Dan, are another huge thing too. Because you see, oftentimes people get close to retirement, want to turn around and sell a business, and they've not thought through how that impacts them, not only their income stream, but their taxes and what it may do to their kids and things that they want to leave. And so all of that plays into it as well. Land is considered, of course, an asset class. And so if you're big in land in one way, it's good to have other things that would diversify your overall asset structure. Because if you have everything tied up, and I'm just saying this as an example, people go out and get all rental property. Well, and then something happens to their health and they can't keep the rental property up. Suddenly, their assets are depreciating. And then they try and sell it and it's not worth as much. You know, all that goes into it. And so you have to be very careful to know that you've got not all your eggs in one basket. And that all of that about the nest, you mentioned, you know, the nest egg, there's feathering your nest. Your nest egg, protecting your nest egg, all that. I'm thinking, why in the world did nobody else come up with the nest financial? Because I think it's so cute now. It's probably so cheesy. Nobody else liked it.
No, I don't think so. I think it's just waiting for you.
I hope so. I hope that's the case. But it is. We look at all that. When people come to start off through the needs analysis, you know, I ask them to tell me off the top of their head, but with as much documentation, what are your overall assets? And then I ask about, do you have land? Do you have rental property? Are your parents going to leave you something? You know, that's the thing. Are you responsible for not only your parents? Do you have kids in their, you know, 20s or 30s? Maybe you're still helping.
Yeah.
And we look at all that to come up with an overall plan.
Well, there's a lot there to consider.
No kidding.
It is.
Absolutely.
It is.
But, okay, so if someone wants to reach you, they can, you mentioned 741-NEST.
NEST, That's 870-741-6378. Because on our smartphones today, you can't spell out NEST, I found out later. But that,
I guess that's true.
Isn't that funny? Somebody, some younger person mentioned that to me. But it's 741-NEST. If I am not there at the office, that rings to my cell phone. So it rolls forward to my cell phone as well.
And you can always leave a message. And you're working out of the home.
Return their home.
Okay. Or, next to, or on the beach.
or on the beach. Yeah, I try not to tell people if I'm on the beach because I'm scared, as I said, that my phone's going to get washed away.
Or sand.
Yeah, or sand in it. And I have actually had an office built into my home, so I have clients in and out of my home a lot, which is good. And kind of a nice thing for the type of conversations we have, you know, sitting down and getting a cup of coffee or a soda and sitting there talking is very... During the snow days, it was heaven. I had people come to the house. We'd sit in front of the fire and drink hot chocolate and talk about their financial future. And it was heaven for them and us. Neat. You know, it was nice.
Well, congratulations on this venture.
I appreciate y'all.
That's Lane Ragsdale and The Nest. And you can contact her. The information was on the screen. Or there's more information at the end of the show. Thank you so much. And come back. Please come back.
We can always tell on the tip of our tongues. It's like we're wanting to go. Lane,
I know.
Ragsdale.
Actually, my cards and everything say Lane Wheeler Ragsdale because so many people say that, oh, I didn't know that was you, and I send them an email, and I'm thinking, how many Lanes did you know to start with? But, yeah, Lane Wheeler Ragsdale, or whatever other name you want to call me, just call me.
Blondie.
That's right, Blondie.
Thanks, Lane. Right,
thank you very much for having me.
All right, up next we have Jamie Nessner from the Diamond Hills International Golf
Invitational Tournament.
It's coming up real soon. We'll talk about that. And we'll take a break. We'll be right back.